Do you know where the longest tunnel in the world is? The 5,000-meter-high Alps is a natural barrier for Italy to the Nordic region since 1980. The traffic volume here has grown rapidly, and the existing roads and railways have reached their limits and are often closed due to bad weather. In order to strengthen the connection between the Nordic countries, engineers decided to build a new tunnel across the Alps. This is the St. Gotthard Base Tunnel in Switzerland, which cost nearly 70 billion and took 17 years to build. It is 57 kilometers long, and its deepest point is more than 2,440 meters from the ground. It consists of two huge tunnels with a diameter of 8 meters, allowing trains to travel at a speed of 250 kilometers per hour for 100 years. To understand the rock conditions around the tunnel, they first dug a smaller exploratory tunnel and then used a 20 million euro rock shield machine to complete the tunnel excavation. At the same time, another group of workers will use explosives to blast and dig cross tunnels and emergency shelters. Although this segmented excavation method can shorten the construction time by half, engineers must ensure that the tunnels can be accurately connected. When building a straight road on the ground, there will be obstacles such as trees, hills, and buildings, which can be easily solved by relying on navigation or high towers. But underground, even the slightest misjudgment can have catastrophic consequences, so engineers can only use GPS to mark the entire tunnel line first. But since there is no satellite signal underground, each shield machine will rely on a laser guidance system to maintain its course. Engineers will install a laser theodolite on the tunnel wall and use the principle of rectilinear propagation of light to guide the shield machine to dig in a straight line to ensure that the tunnel direction does not deviate. Because the shield machine is too large, in order to facilitate transportation from Germany to the construction site, engineers disassembled it into sections and transported it to the dock. Then hundreds of heavy trucks were used to cross mountains and narrow roads to deliver hundreds of thousands of parts to the entrance of the tunnel. In the next 4 months, the shield machine will be reassembled here. Although this tunnel is only 57 kilometers long, it took 17 years to build. Every day, this shield machine can dig forward 20 meters, but when it encounters squeezing rock layers, it must stop. It took a total of 17 years to build this tunnel. When many workers first built the tunnel, their children were still in elementary school. After the construction was completed, their grandchildren were born. In order to build this tunnel, the engineering team used 4 million tons of concrete, which is equivalent to 40 times the world's tallest building, the Burj Khalifa. They excavate about 2,000 tons of rubble every day, and then transport it to the outside of the tunnel through a conveyor belt. The factory here will recycle the rubble and process it into concrete ring segments. Not keeping up with the progress of the shield machine, the segments will be transported to the depths of the tunnel 24 hours a day. Workers use mechanical arms to install the 4-ton concrete segments to the appropriate position. These segments are of different sizes and different interfaces. Each piece contains two layers of thick waterproof membranes. Workers must assemble them carefully to ensure the integrity of the tunnel. As the shield machine moves forward, workers pour concrete on the outer layer of the segments to enhance the tunnel strength. The inner wall of the tunnel was also formed synchronously, and the workers behind installed the track and signal system at the same time. But when the shield machine encountered softer squeezed rock, the workers had to use the initial drilling and blasting method. In order to speed up the progress of the project, they used an advanced 3D rock drilling trolley, which sprayed water while the drill bit rotated to cool the constantly heated drill bit and improve the working environment of the workers. In order to break the rock into small pieces that can be cleaned, each explosive will explode with the next explosive for a millisecond of rock. After the blasting is completed, the surface of the rock wall is uneven, and the workers will spray a layer of concrete on the surface and support it with concentric ring brackets. This bracket is different from the traditional rigid arch frame. It can move within a certain range and resist the pressure of mountain squeezing. Although building this tunnel was a very challenging project, the workers persisted and finally successfully completed the task. So, what kind of tunnel is safe? The train is running in the tunnel, and the view is not wide. In order to ensure the safety of passengers, the engineers of the St. Gotthard Base Tunnel designed two one-way tracks, which completely prevented the collision of two trains, but they still faced the threat of fire. In 1999, a serious fire accident occurred in the 11-kilometer Mont Blanc Road tunnel. A truck suddenly caught fire in the center of the tunnel. The fire quickly engulfed more than 30 cars around it. The tunnel was filled with a lot of smoke, and the surrounding temperature instantly soared to more than 1,000 degrees. It took more than 50 firefighters 3 days to put it out, and the fire killed 39 people, most of whom died from inhaling toxic fumes. The Gotthard Base Tunnel is 57 kilometers long, and the consequences would be disastrous if a fire broke out. Therefore, engineers built 3 emergency shelters inside the tunnel. Passengers can enter the 470-meter-long central shelter through fire doors, where they can wait for rescuers, who will use another tunnel to get there. To prevent toxic gases from entering the shelter, the ventilation system will be remotely activated, and powerful fans above the track will suck in toxic fumes and exhaust them from the exhaust vents above. At the same time, imported fans will replenish clean air in the tunnel. This ingenious safety system adds 38.5 million francs to each shelter. The total cost reached 95.6 billion Swiss francs, which is equivalent to about 68.1 billion yuan. According to official data, the tunnel only reduced the travel time between Milan and Zurich by 50 minutes, which is not much more efficient, but it can better withstand the changing climate and traffic of the mountains, making trade between European countries closer. In short, the Gotthard Base Tunnel is a testament to the ingenuity and skill of modern engineering. It is an incredible achievement that connects countries and enables faster and more efficient transportation. Who knows? Maybe one day you will have the opportunity to experience this impressive tunnel in person. Thanks for joining me on this tour of Gotthard Base Tunnel. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more amazing content. See you next time.